Hi, so welcome back to my YouTube channel, and of course, like I said in the previous video, please like, comment and share. The topic for today might seem very controversial to some of you, but I can assure you that's my independent thoughts. This is what I think. It's my opinion. I'm not trying to force it down your throats. I'm just trying to maybe lay an unpopular opinion. You know, we're Africans, and I think mine is made worse by the fact that I am Igbo. I'm not just Igbo, I am very Anambra. And for most Africans, women, you know, were made to marry, procreate, and take care or nurture children. But this is like my opinion, this is what I think. I'm not trying to force you to believe it or see things my way. But let's see this in another light. Most of the women I know married because it was the thing to do. It was the time to get married. They didn't really marry because they felt they are ready or that they even want to. Funniest part, most women think they do not have a choice, as in you have to get married. I've been married for 11 years and it took me some time to realize that I was actually meant to marry. But I have friends who do not want to marry. Like, not that they didn't see husband, but they don't want to marry. And no, they're not going to hell. No, they are not feminists. No, they do not hate men. No, they just don't want to marry. And there are some other women who, I don't think, I'm not saying that they are too independent to marry, but it's like there's that gene missing, that thing that says, you need to share with somebody, you need to share your life with somebody, you need to be accountable to somebody else for yourself, your well-being, your whereabouts. Some people do not like that. Some people do not have the time for that. And this is what causes problems in some marriages I have seen. Now, if you cannot share, if you cannot forgive when offended, if you cannot hold yourself accountable or have someone hold you accountable for certain stuff that you see as your own exclusive right or preserve, you have no business marrying, at least for now. That's just the honest truth. And I've seen myself do stuff that ordinarily before now I would have said, oh, how can I do that? But that's what marriage entails. Now let's even talk about the other side, having kids. Did you know that it's not everybody that was meant to have kids? Like, do you know? Some women are missing the maternity or the maternal gene. Some people do not want the burden a child brings. Yes, and children are burdens. Yes, they are. Nobody should deceive you. They are burdens. Luckily, for a lot of us or a lot of people, they are burdens you would gladly carry, burdens you would gladly bear, because you feel at the end of the day, the end will justify the means. Some people do not have that gene. That is why you see some women have kids and without any backward look, walk away from them. Some men would have kids and they would live very happy lives without thinking for a second. What are my kids doing? Who are they calling daddy? How are they feeding? How are they faring without me? They do not want to be fathers, but society somehow ropes them into responsibilities they want no part of. So which one are you, or have you ever given any thought to this? Do you think we are all meant to marry, all meant to have kids simply because that is the thing to do? The Bible says you should go into the world and procreate, go into the world and multiply. Did you marry because you really, really want to marry? I have friends who got married and left the marriages, not because their partners were bad, not because their partners were toxic or abusive, but simply because they couldn't meet up with the demands of being married. They couldn't. They wanted to live by themselves, for themselves, being accountable to no other person. She wants to stand up today and leave and go elsewhere without anybody asking her where she's going to, without any kids having to, you know, drag her and say, mommy, I'm here. And truly, for me, I think that's fine. The most important thing is to know where you fall in. Where do you belong? Are you in the marrying class? Or are you in the not marrying class? For some people, I think it's a phase that they pass. You know, after a while, when they've lived to a certain level, they get past that. But for some, that is who they are. So I think the secret is in listening to your partner. By partner, I don't mean your husband, because when you're married, the deed is done. But by your partner, I mean your boyfriend, your girlfriend, your fiance. Listen when they tell you what they want. Listen when they say things they like to do and things they do not like to do. Most times we miss the cues because we hear what we want to hear. You know, my 11 years, it's not like 11 years is a lot, truly. But at least it's given me some perspective. You know, I am seeing and understanding stuff that maybe I didn't some time ago. But now, I'm just seeing it in a different light. So, which one do you fall in? The married type, the not marrying, the will marry later? But I tell you, one of the worst things you can do is to get married before you're ready. Marriage is not just about wedding pictures, pre-wedding shoots, bridal showers, bachelors. If it's as in, it's much more than choosing your wedding color. But if you're the marrying kind and you married, kudos, continue to do just like me. If you are not, the Lord be with you as you explain to your mother. Say, you know what, Mary, I don't envy you. As in, really, don't cut the video, you'll be looking at me.